first selection is Nobles of the Mystic Shrine by John Philip Sousa. Published in 1923, this concert-oriented march celebrates John Philip Sousa's membership in the ancient Arabic order of the Nobles of the Mystic Shrine, or most commonly known as the Shriners. His local chapter hosted the National Convention in 1923 in Washington, D.C., and Sousa conducted a band of 6,200 members in Griffith Stadium, the largest group he ever conducted. Contemporary versions of the Janissary Band are a vital part of colorful shrine marching units, and this march was intended to recreate the musical style of this Turkish music. Please welcome to the stage Mr. Thompson and the Lassiter Symphonic One Band with Nobles of the Mystic Shrine. Harmonic and rhythmic possibilities in keeping with the demands of the symphonic performance. Armenian Dances was first performed by Dr. Perry Bijim, to whom it is dedicated, and the University of Illinois Symphonic Band in 1973 for the National CBDNA Conference. This year marks the 50th anniversary of this band standard. The Lassiter High School Symphonic One Band continues their program with Alfred Reed's Armenian Dances.
Thank you.
Kelly writes, Mount Vesuvius, the volcano that destroyed Pompeii in AD 79, is an icon of power and energy in this work. Originally, I had in mind a wild and passionate dance, such as might have been performed in ancient Roman Bacchanalia. During the compositional process, I began to envision something more explosive and fiery. With its driving rhythms, exotic modes, and quotations from the Dies Irae from the medieval Requiem Mass, it became evident that the Bacchanalia I was writing could represent a dance from the final days of the doomed city of Pompeii. The Lassiter High School Symphonic One Band concludes their program this evening with Frank Ticelli's Vesuvius.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Lyceum High School with Black Wonder, Sister James Thompson Jr. Thank you.